thing you want to watch so that you are not deceived. Now, how will the false prophet deceive the people of the world? Through the miracles that you have power to perform. In Revelation chapter 16, reading from verse 13 and verse 14. Revelation chapter 16, verse 13. And I saw three unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon, and out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet. You'll see three personalities mentioned here: the dragon, that's Satan; then the false beast, that is the Antichrist; and then you have the false prophet himself. And it says it's the same kind of spirits coming out of them, and they're like frogs, and they are unclean. In verse 14, for they are the spirits of devils. The spirit coming out of the dragon is of the devil. Out of the Antichrist is the devil. And the one out of the false prophet is also of the devil. For they are the spirits of devils walking miracles. Walking miracles. And there are some people that run after miracles. And anywhere they hear the miracles are being performed, they run there. And they say, well, after all, it's a supernatural thing that is taking place there. If God is not there, why will they be performing miracles? You need to understand that the devil is not a natural personality. It's a supernatural personality. And the Antichrist will not just have natural power, political power alone. He'll have supernatural power as well. As well now, the false prophet will not just depend on psychology, on whatever it is, philosophy. It will also have the power of the devil, having the spirit of the devil by which he operates. It says in that verse 14, for they are the spirits of the devils, working miracles, which go forth unto the kings of the earth and of the whole world to gather them to battle, or to the battle of that great day of God Almighty. And we're told in Matthew chapter 24, here are the words of Jesus Christ concerning the days of the great tribulation, the days of deception, the days when miracles will be performed so as to deceive people. And you will hear all over the world that, here there is a miracle going on, here there are miracles going on, in the other place there are miracles going on. And when you hear about those things and read them in the newspapers, even the details alone will show that these cannot be of the Spirit of God. Because as you compare them with the scriptures, there's no righteousness there, there's no repentance there, there is no holiness there, there is no exaltation of the Lord Jesus Christ there, and there is no desire to get to heaven there. No study of the Bible, just miracle, miracle. That will show you then that the source of that miracle is not clean. The source is not of God. And because the source is not of God, that's why you're not going to give yourself, give in to them, so that you will not be deceived. We're told in Matthew chapter 24, reading from verse 1, for there shall be great tribulation, such as was not since the beginning of the world to this time, no nor ever shall be. These are the words of the Lord Jesus Christ himself. And it says, except those days should be shortened, there should no flesh be saved, but for the elect's sake, those days shall be shortened. And then it says in verse 23, then, if any man shall say unto you, look, here is Christ, or there, believe it not. That you see, they say, miracles are taking place. Supernatural things are taking place. And because these miracles and supernatural things are taking place, let's go there. Christ is there. And the followers of Christ are there. And the ministers of Christ are there. It says, don't listen to them. Don't follow them. It will be very serious at the time of the great tribulation, and it is still very serious today. As many people today are running about, I've heard there's a miracle taking place in the other place, and some people are going to be inviting you. I've gone there and see me now, see what I've got. Business has changed. My wife now is carrying a baby, and this is not taking place. This is not taking place. It says, don't go. Don't run after miracles. What's the source of the miracle? Who are the originators of those miracles? Who are the people perpetrating those miracles? Who are the people working those miracles? Is there the study of the Word of God? Is there repentance there? Are backsliders being restored into the faith? Are the people who are receiving those miracles, are they honoring the Lord, glorifying the Lord, exalting the Lord? Are they making restitutions? Are they having transformations and changes in their lives? If not, then you understand that this will not be, that will not be of God. That's why it says in verse 24, for there shall arise false Christs and false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders. they will show great signs and wonders, insomuch that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect. And then in verse 25, behold, I've told you before. That's the Lord Jesus Christ warning us, saying, He has told us before. That's why it says in verse 26, wherefore, if they shall say unto you, behold, he is in the desert, go not forth. Behold, he is in the secret chamber, believe it not. At the time in which we are living now, we know that the Antichrist already is walking by spirit and is deceiving many, many people. I pray that we will not be deceived in Jesus' name. We're told in 1 John chapter 2, looking at verse 18. It says, little children, it's the last time. As ye have heard, the Antichrist shall come. That the Antichrist, that is just one Antichrist, the final one, come. Even now are there many Antichrists. That's what I told you. That events of the Great Tribulation will cast their shadows before them. Actually, before that Great Tribulation. That's why it says, even now there are many Antichrists, whereby we know it is the last time. In chapter 4, 1 John chapter 4, reading from verse 1, beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits, ever they are of God. Because many false prophets are gone out into the world. That's the reason that you need to be very careful, because there are lying wonders all around. This lamp like false prophet is just an imitation. It's a counterfeit. It's a deceiver. He'll be imitating all the things of the Lord, and then he will deceive them that dwell on the face of the earth by the means of those miracles that he has power to do. But the Bible reports things as lying wonders. Lying wonders. And they will be used to deceive the people on the earth to worship the Antichrist. Look at 2 Thessalonians once again. 2 Thessalonians, reading from chapter 2. Chapter 2, reading from verse 9. Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, with all signs and all power and signs and lying of wonders. The wonders are supposed to deceive. That's exactly the intention of the devil, is to deceive the people that are not very observant, and to deceive the people that are looking for miracles at all costs. Miracles that will take them away from heaven. Miracles that will attach them to the devil. Miracles that will destroy their soul. Miracles that will lead them into hell. The people that are looking for miracles, miracles, miracles at all costs, and they will not examine the cause and the origin of the miracle, they will go to a direction of perishing. Because eventually we are told, all those who are influenced by those miracles of the false prophets, they will be doomed, they will be damned, and they will be sent to the lake of fire forever and ever. Look at Revelation chapter 14. Revelation chapter 14, reading from verse 9. And a third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image, and receive the mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation, and he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. And the smoke of their torment ascendeth up forever and ever. And they have no rest day nor night to worship the beast and his image, and whosoever receiveth the mark of his name. Before I go away from that first point, let's just remind ourselves that the things that the does, and the things that the Antichrist will do, and the things that the false prophets will do, and the false prophets of today, the danger of deception, the danger of deception. Number one, there is delusion. What that means is that when the devil begins to do those things, through the false prophets, if you are staying near them, and you are staying close to them, the first thing will be delusion. You'll be saying, but oh, what's wrong in this? What are they talking about? Look at this miracle now. Look at the power now. They just talk about holiness, holiness, holiness all the time. And heaven all the time. And we don't see this kind of thing. Look at the power that these people have. And then the number one effect upon you will be delusion. In Jeremiah chapter 23. Jeremiah chapter 23, I'm reading from verse 15. Therefore thus says the Lord of hosts concerning the prophets, behold, I will feed them with wormwood and make them drink the water of God. For from the prophets of Jerusalem is filthiness gone forth into all the land. Thus says the Lord of hosts, hearken not unto the words of the prophets that prophesy unto you. They make you vain. They speak a vision of their own heart, and not out of the mouth of the Lord. They say still unto them that despise me, the Lord has said, ye shall have peace. That is, they will be talking to the people that are despising God, dishonoring God, disobeying God. They will say, don't worry, you'll have peace. There's no problem. God is not going to judge you. God is the God of grace. And then he says, and they shall say unto everyone that walketh after the imagination of his own heart, no evil shall be upon you. No evil shall come upon you. They will be talking to backsliders. They will be talking to sinners. They will be saying, there's no consequence. Be free. Do whatever you want to do. And that is the mark of false prophets. Until the people are deluded, until they are so deceived, they begin to believe a lie. For in verse 18, for who has stood in the counsel of the Lord and has perceived and heard his word? Who has marked his word and heard it? Behold, the whirlwind of the Lord is gone forth in fury, even a grievous whirlwind. It shall fall grievously upon the head of the wicked. The anger of the Lord shall not return until he has executed, until he has performed the thoughts of his heart. In the latter days it shall come. Ye shall consider it perfectly. The number one effect of the deception is that there will be delusion. Number two, there will be distaste for the truth. Distaste for the truth. When you visit the false prophets and you stay in the presence of false prophets, and then they talk about miracles, miracles all the time, you will grow a distaste, a dislike for the word of God, for the sound doctrine of the Bible. When we preach a doctrine, when we preach the truth of the word of God, when we preach the holiness without which no man shall see the Lord, you'll not be interested anymore. Your mind turn to another thing. That's what we're told in 2 Timothy chapter 4. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 3 and 4. But the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. They'll have distaste, dislike for sound doctrine. They will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own laws shall they heed to themselves teachers in itching ears, and it shall turn away their ears from the truth. They dislike it. They don't want it. They turn their ears away from the truth and shall be turned to fables. Number three, a departure from the faith. A departure from the faith. When these things happen, the effect on the minds of people will be that they have departure from the faith. In 1 Timothy chapter 4, reading from verses 1 up to 2. 1 Timothy chapter 4, verses 1 to 2. Now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times shall depart from the faith. If well, only those who are preaching something, only those who are preaching the word of God, only those who are preaching the totality of the Bible, it will be difficult for people to turn away from the faith. But when there are so many churches, so many assemblies, and so many false prophets, and so many false doctrines, and they are backing up the false doctrine with miracles, and people, they are writing in the papers, and you are hearing it over the radio, it's on television, it's on cassette, it's on CD, it's on F, it's everywhere, and people are busy distributing them. Miracles are taking place. Leave all these doctrines alone, all this holiness that has not given you a wife, all the holiness that has not given you a husband, all the holiness you have not bought a car, all the holiness you have not got a children, leave all that alone. We're talking about miracles. Come and see wonder. And then the minds of people are turned away from the truth. And then those who are saved before, they will give up, and they'll be departing from the faith. The Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, speaking lies in hypocrisy, having their conscience seared with a hot iron. It would be like, their hearts are seared with a hot iron. Number four, the result of such a deception is that there will be divine displeasure. Divine displeasure. The Lord will be against them, and the Lord will show his fury, his anger, his wrath, his indignation, his judgment against such people and all the people that run after them. Jeremiah chapter 23 again. In Jeremiah chapter 23, reading from verse 25, I have heard what the prophet said, prophesied lies in my name, saying, I have dreamed. How long shall this be in the heart of the prophets that prophesy lies? yea, they are prophets of the deceit of their own heart, which seem to cause my people to forget my name by their dreams. They cause my people to forget my name, and forget my covenant, and forget my statutes, and forget my doctrine, and forget my demand, my request upon their life, which cause my people to forget my name by their dreams, which every man to his neighbor, and a father for my neighbor, and they have us therefore against the Lord. Displeasure, divine displeasure, and against prophets, says the Lord, that use their tongues and say that steal my words, everyone from his neighbor. Five, there will be death and destruction. Death and destruction. And that destruction will be sudden. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. When that deception comes, then the people, they are deluded already. And they are saying, no problem anymore. God is a good Lord. There's no judgment. There's no law. And all they are talking about Antichrist. And they are talking about this and that. Is this one Antichrist, the one working miracle? Is this one Antichrist, the one that is giving us food? Is this one Antichrist, the one that is blessing our lives? Is this Antichrist, the one that is making his way through us? And while they are saying peace, peace, sudden destruction will come upon them. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 3. For when they shall say, peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them, as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. Finally, there will be damnation. Damnation. In 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 12, that they all might be damned who believed not the truth, but had pleasure in unrighteousness. The final thing is that there will be damnation. That's the danger of the deception. Number one, delusion. Number two, distaste, dislike for the truth. Number three, departure from the faith. Number four, divine displeasure. Number five, death and destruction. Number six, damnation. And that's the reason why you need to be watchful. It says here that they all might be damned. The false prophets and the people that follow them, they are the people to be damned. It is not only the false prophet, the climax and the greatest of the false prophets, the one that is still to come, not only that one that will be cast into the lake of fire, but all the false prophets that ever deceived anyone into error, they will be cast into the lake of fire too, because they will have damnation on the final day. 2 Peter chapter 2, reading from verse 1. 2 Peter chapter 2 from verse 1. But there were false prophets among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you. There shall be false teachers among you. That's why you need to take care in the districts. You need to take care in your community. You need to take care anywhere you are, any town you go to. And sometimes you travel out of town and there is no deeper life there. You say, today is Sunday, I need to just go to a church. And then you enter a church and you see what they're doing. You hear what they are preaching. Be very careful. You don't give in just easily like that. Or some of us, you have all these international evangelists, international churches, international preachers, especially in this time of internet. And this time of information technology, and they're saying that you can have this and you can have that, and then you are contacting them. You can buy their cases, you can buy this and you can buy that, and eventually you are being deceived and being sold into those things, and they'll be inviting you to international gatherings, international meetings, and then they rope you in, and by then you know that you're in the midst of false prophets, and you are knee deep and shoulder and head and everything inside the false doctrine. You might be counting the cost. It's difficult for you to come out now because you spent so much money there and they have promised you quite a lot. And if you back out now, are you not going to miss what they have promised you already? That's why you need to be very careful. There shall be false teachers among you, and they will bring in damnable heresies, even denying the Lord that bought them, and bring upon them such swift destruction. And many shall follow their pernicious ways, by reason of whom the way of truth shall be evil spoken of, and through covetousness shall they with vain words make merchandise of you, whose judgment now of a long time lingereth not, and their damnation slumbereth not. And that's the reason we're careful. That's the reason we're not in and out. Everywhere we hear that, somebody is performing miracles somewhere. That tells us of the description, the portrait of the false prophet. We go to point number two. deception, through the power of the false prophet. Deception through the power of the false prophet. I come to Revelation chapter 13. In Revelation chapter 13, we're looking at verse 13 through to verse 15.